Madam President, let the 30th graduate commencement at Muskingum University now begin.
Thank you, Dr. Schroer. And I am delighted to welcome all of you to our 2020 graduate commencement. It is such a pleasure to celebrate this with each of you in person, with our graduate class of 2022, with friends and family. And we will also be capturing this on film to share with those who will not or were not able to join us this evening. So I'm going to ask everyone right now to please rise in body or spirit for our invocation led by our Muskingum University chaplain, the Reverend Julia Wright.
Please join me in prayer. God of journeys, as we celebrate an ending, we pray that you open our eyes to each new beginning. Help us to look back on the beautiful things we have seen and done in our time at Muskingum, and guide our graduates as they look towards the beauty before them. Help us to set aside any regrets or struggles that we may have faced on our journey thus far and find gratitude for the people that we have become. We give you thanks for all those who are able to gather with us this evening to celebrate, and we remember those who are unable to join us. Remind us all that even though we might be separated after this commencement ceremony, we are all present together in spirit. We give you thanks for the devotion of the teachers and staff who have invested so much into our students, preparing them for the world beyond our campus. We give thanks for the perseverance and commitment of our graduating students, for their hard work and their ability to never give up, never stop learning, and never stop working towards this exciting day. Help us be present in this moment. Let us live into this exciting time. Fill each of us with gladness, love, and hope for the future. Amen. Please be seated.
There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny world so invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain, for one thing or other, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. I found magic, but they won't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. They all be it. 'Cause I have wings, yes, I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. And one day soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. My own planets and stars are glowing. No one notices anything. Not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing. wing, that I have wings. Yes, I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. Well, one day soon you will hear my plea. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe. Please believe in me. Yes, I have wings, and I can fly around the moon, far beyond the sky. You called my name, and you set me free. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe. Who believes in me?
Thank you, Carter, for that wonderful performance. That was from our April musical, Zoozical the Musical, in which Carter was Horton and did a wonderful job in a really dynamic show. So thank you. So congratulations to our 2022 graduate degree class. This is your day, and the Muskingum University community is delighted to celebrate with you. Each one of you has made an impact during your time with Muskingum. Your passion for your field has led you to earn your Master of Education, Master of Arts in Teaching, Master of Business Information Systems, and Master of Occupational Therapy degrees. I am confident that as educators, business leaders, occupational therapists, and members of your communities, you will continue to transform the lives of others. And we are especially proud that tonight we are going to be presenting our first Master of Business Information Systems degree in the university's history. And so we have one student receiving that degree. We're going to thank that person for being a trailblazer in this program, which was actually reimagined from our Master of Information Strategy Systems and Technology program. So we are committed to ensuring that all of our graduates have the best possible programming and that we are creating programs for you that are relevant and responsive and make you ready for the future. So class of 2022, we know that you would not have succeeded in earning your advanced degree without the support of your family and friends. So we now want to say congratulations to you, family members and friends, and to say a big thank you for supporting and encouraging your loved one through each milestone along the way to earning their degrees. We share your tremendous pride in them. And those of you in the audience here tonight who are especially thinking about that support from your family and friends and those who have helped you along the way, let's all give these family and friends a round of applause for their exceptional support. So the Muskingum faculty and staff have been at the center of your experience with us, teaching, challenging, inspiring, and guiding you. And today they honor you. So we would like to give that honor back. Would the Muskingum University faculty and staff please stand and be recognized? And this evening, we are especially delighted to welcome a group of people who provide a great deal of service to this university. The Muskingum University Board of Trustees is a highly committed and engaged group of individuals. They have had an enormous impact on this institution through their leadership and their stewardship. Would the members of the Board of Trustees who are with us today, this evening, please stand and be recognized? So this year's graduate commencement address will be presented by Ekman J. Remedo III, a 2011 graduate of our Master of Information Strategy, Systems, and Technology program. And we are delighted to welcome Ed and his wife, Colleen, back to our campus for this special evening. So Ed is the Chief Transformation Officer for the Genesis Healthcare System after serving Genesis for 13 years as the system's Chief Information Officer. The impact he has had on Genesis, on the area, residents it serves, and on our regional community is truly inspiring. We are extremely proud to honor him today with the presentation of a Doctor of Humane Letters degree. So I'm going to invite Dr. Kim Gage Rothermel, the chair of the university's Board of Trustees, to join me in conferring this honorary degree.
Whereas Edmund J. Romito III, a member of the Muskingum Master of Information Strategy, Systems, and Technology degree class of 2011, impacts the world through his more than 37 years of dedicated service to healthcare leadership and healthcare information management. And whereas Edmund J. Romito III has served the Genesis healthcare systems and helped meet the healthcare needs of Southeastern Ohio residents since 1995. First as Director of Information Systems, Healthcare Information Management, and Biomedical Engineering, then as Chief Information Officer, and currently as Chief Transformation Officer. And whereas Edmund J. Romito III builds and leads high-performing staff teams whose work has resulted in Genesis Healthcare System receiving national recognition among its peers as a top 100 places to work in IT 8 times and as a most wired hospital 5 times. And whereas Edmund J. Romito III has demonstrated a lifelong commitment to learning, earning a Bachelor of Science degree in Computer and Information Sciences from The Ohio State University's College of Engineering, and credentials from the Healthcare Information and Management Systems Society as a certified professional in healthcare information and management systems, and from the College of Healthcare Information Management Executives as a certified healthcare chief information officer. And whereas Edmund J. Romito III serves his community through volunteer leadership activities with the Boy Scouts of America and the United Way. Therefore, be it now resolved by the Muskingum University Board of Trustees on this, the 5th day of May, 2022, that the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters be conferred upon Edmund J. Romito III.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of Ohio and the Board of Trustees of Muskingum University, I do hereby confer upon you Edmund J. Remito III, the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. I am honored now to present to you Dr. Edmund J. Remito III, who told us he prefers to be called Ed.
Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here. President Hassler, distinguished faculty, administration, graduating classes, families, and friends, this is an extremely special evening. We're all able to be together. I think that's the first time in 2 years that we've been able to do this. So I'm truly honored to be here to celebrate this very special occasion with you. Amazingly, it was May 5th, 2011, exactly 11 years ago tonight, I was sitting where you are, graduating with a Master's of Information Strategy, Systems, and Technology degree. I'm sure each of you have your own stories of the path that led you to graduate school. I'd like to take a few moments to share my path, the impact Muskingum University had on me, and how graduate studies here at Muskingum changed the trajectory of my career. Since my undergraduate degree, I had explored graduate studies. However, I just couldn't find the right time to commit to doing graduate work. As I continued my research, I learned of Muskingum's new innovative MIS program. Talked to a few people in the program, was really intrigued. I had a lot going on in my personal life. Our son was a busy high schooler, involved in sports, Boy Scouts, many other activities, including preparing for his own college journey. I was equally busy at Genesis Healthcare System, where we had just started a $50 million project to implement a new electronic medical record system. This was a massive, multi-year, strategic, and transformative project involving a team of over 150 people, and it was the largest non-brick-and-mortar investment Genesis has ever made in its history. I talked to Mary Kaufman, who was the MIST advisor at that time, about the structure and demands of the program. It was clear Mary was no stranger to this conversation. I had concerns about finding time to do the program, probably like many of you did. It was then that Mary said, "You know, there's never a good time to start. You just need to do it." And at that point, I made the decision with my wife, Colleen, who's here tonight supporting me, and I embarked on my graduate career here at Muskingum. Interesting side note, it appears that maybe Colleen was channeling Mary, because recently, through the pandemic and some personal stressful personal events, she introduced me to the phrase, "What are we waiting for? Let's just do it." So this is now the mantra that we live our lives by and is going to guide the rest of our journey together. Now, with my journey to find a graduate program finally over, I began my first class. It had been 24 years since I was in college. I'm sure many of you have similar stories about going back to school. The first class was a bit rough, but I started to find my groove. And like many of you may have experienced, then I encountered the class that you remember for the rest of your life. This class, for me, was INFR 512, Business Strategy. The course would challenge me, but also provide me the epiphany that would change the trajectory of my career. However, at that time, I didn't know it. And by the way, INFR 512 is the only class number I remember out of any of the classes I took that had that much impact on me. And I know that class is still in existence for the current MBIS. A little background on this course. It was a course focusing on business strategy and value and the importance of creativity and innovation. The main project involved the topic of innovation in business and the importance of innovation to the strategic value to a company and the viability of organizations seemed like a fairly straightforward project. However, at The Ohio State University, I was trained as an engineer. I was taught to think a certain way, left brain, very analytical, look at data, solve a problem, look at data, solve a problem. This was not that kind of work. It began to really tap a creativity skill set that was really unfamiliar to me. I spent weekends and evenings researching innovation, working on presentations, trying different ideas, starting and restarting. This project was challenging me in ways that I've never been challenged before. I ultimately completed the project and delivered what I believe to be a creative and inspirational story. My remaining work at MIST expanded on these thoughts and equipped me with not only the skills, but a new way of thinking. Not what to think, but how to think. My work in this space was a major factor for my success since my graduation and was one of the key reasons I've moved into my new role as Genesis Healthcare's Chief Transformation Officer. As you can see, Muskingum University had a profound impact on me both personally and professionally, and I'm sure you all have similar stories. I'd like to spend a few minutes on innovation and the importance to everyone here tonight, regardless of where your paths take you from here. Innovation is very, very interesting to study. In some cases, it's very visible. We can all see it very well. In other cases, it goes relatively unnoticed. Many of us are familiar with great innovators, people like Steve Jobs with Apple, Bill Gates with Microsoft, Jeff Bezos, Amazon, Larry Page started Google, Elon Musk, very familiar with Tesla, SpaceX, and PayPal, Mark Zuckerberg, Facebook, and Meta, and Spencer Silver, 3M. All very recognizable names with very visible track records in innovation. Well, almost everyone. Does anybody recognize that last name, Spencer Silver? I didn't. Never heard of the person. Well, Spencer Silver was a chemist working for 3M, the multinational company. He was working on developing a better adhesive, one that was stronger, tougher than any adhesive that has ever been developed before. He developed what he thought was an innovative adhesive, and it was based on this concept of microspheres. But it had none of these characteristics. In fact, it was actually the total opposite. It was weak and removable. This really frustrated Spencer because his whole plan was to find the ultimate adhesive. He failed to achieve his desired goal. It's a great example of the risks innovators face, and a great example that failure to achieve your initial goal may ultimately be an opportunity to take what you learned and apply it to a new problem. This failure was always on Spencer's mind as he worked on other projects. And then one day, one of his 3M colleagues came to him and was talking about a problem he was having with bookmarks falling out of his choir hymnal. And Spencer asked then a very powerful question. What if? What if we use this failed adhesive on these bookmarks? It was perfect. It held the bookmarks in place, but allowed them to be removed without damaging the pages. It was that day that the 3M Post-it note was born. From its humble beginning, the Post-it note would become the ubiquitous fixture in every office and every home. We all have them. We all use them. Pretty amazing. The Post-it note was a product at that time that nobody thought they needed until they did. Spencer Silver asked that most powerful question, what if? And there are similar stories like this, including the innovators at Pizza Hut, maybe not as glamorous as the Post-it note. They asked, what if we put cheese in the crust of a pizza? And oh my gosh, are we lucky they did that, because it took pizza to the next level. So generally speaking, the main purpose of innovation isn't to improve people's lives. Those names I gave examples of, they have demonstrated history of just doing things to help us improve our lives. In its simple form, it can be described as doing something different. However, the result of innovation should always be an improvement. And from a society's perspective, the fundamental outcomes of innovation are economic growth, improved health and wellness, educational accessibility, and environmental sustainability. Almost all innovation activities are not necessarily power enough to save the world or even change the world, but they are powerful enough to change the things around you. They do not need to be typically and are not typically massive in scope. Small improvements eventually grow to bigger and bigger ideas and someday become very revolutionary, like the adhesive Spencer Silver invented. In the meantime, however, you have an amazing opportunity to make remarkable improvements within your own sphere of influence. Often getting started is the hardest part. There are many ways to approach innovation. You should, however, focus on something you're passionate about. Start small, pick your focus, because you can't fix everything at once. And as in the Post-it note story, don't be afraid to fail. That failure could open the door to something great. There are examples all around us, some small in scale, others very large, some that made our lives easier, some that changed lives forever, and some, more importantly, saved lives. Innovation was critical as we navigated the pandemic over the past 2+ years. This innovation led to life-saving treatments, new drug therapies, vaccination technologies that were delivered at speeds never seen before. Genesis Healthcare System quickly implemented a virtual video visit technology that allowed patients to see their physicians and care teams in a safe environment. Our very own community, there were local companies that shut down their normal operations to produce specially designed personal protective devices that were in short supply at hospitals. The innovation is happening all around Muskingum University and around the campus. The Impact 2025 strategic plan is delivering innovative, transformative initiatives to enhance the student experience and create a learning environment where every student can thrive. We also saw on February 3rd of this year a set of in-the-moment innovations right here on campus when Muskingum University experienced a 26-hour electrical outage due to a winter storm. It was innovative thinking that kept students, faculty, and staff safe and warm and fed. Faculty prepared to offer courses remotely, and Wi-Fi network was maintained so that communication and learning can continue. You see, innovation happens all around us every day, some very apparent, some very impactful, while others improve our lives but go relatively unnoticed. Muskingum University has prepared you to be creative, innovative thinkers. I have no doubt you are all going to be successful and accomplish remarkable things. I encourage all the graduates here this evening to continue a journey of lifelong learning and keep asking those so important questions: what if, why, and why not? And most importantly, don't be afraid to fail. Steve Jobs summed up his work and goals best when he said, "All I want to do is put a ding in the universe." Well, I would say he did much more than that. I challenge you to take what you learned here in your time at Muskingum University, incorporate innovation in all that you do, and put your own ding in the universe. Thank you, and congratulations on this phenomenal achievement.
Thank you, Ed. It was an amazing challenge to innovate and be fearless and move forward in this time of new beginnings for each one of you. So as we prepare to grant degrees to the graduate class of 2022, I invite our provost, Dr. Nancy Evangelista, to join me for the presentation of candidates.
Thank you, Dr. Heston. Are we ready? Yeah, are we ready? Thank you. Yes. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts and Education degree please stand? MA. Madam President, these candidates have completed all the requirements as set by the faculty for the Master of Arts and Education degree. The faculty has recommended and the Board of Trustees have approved the granting of.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty with the approval of the Board of Trustees and by virtue of the authority placed in me by the State of Ohio, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Arts in Education with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations.
And now, will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Teaching degree please stand? Madam President, these candidates have completed all the requirements as set by the faculty for the Master of Arts in Teaching degree. The faculty has recommended and the Board of Trustees has approved the granting of these degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and with the approval of the Board of Trustees and by virtue of the authority placed in me by the State of Ohio, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Arts in Teaching with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Will the candidate for the Master of Business Information Systems degree please stand? This candidate has completed all the requirements as set by the faculty for the Master of Business Information Systems degree. The faculty has recommended and the Board of Trustees has approved the granting of this degree.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty with the approval of the Board of Trustees and by virtue of the authority placed in me by the State of Ohio, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Business Information Systems with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Will the candidates for the Master of Occupational Therapy degree please stand? These candidates have completed all the requirements as set by the faculty for the Master of Occupational Therapy degree. The faculty has recommended and the Board of Trustees has approved the granting of these degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty with the approval of the Board of Trustees and by virtue of the authority placed in me by the State of Ohio, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Occupational Therapy with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Of the degrees of Master of Arts in Education, Master of Arts in Teaching, Master of Business Information Systems, and Master of Occupational Therapy to come forward to be put in and to receive your diplomas. I also invite Chair Ralph Rommel, Dr. Mark Sanford, Dr. Timothy Slepper, and Dr. Mary Armour to come forward to assist in the hooding and diploma presentation. Families of our graduates, please remain seated as we are unable to accommodate movement to the stage due to social distancing. Graduates, you may now rise and be ushered forward.
I will note that we can accommodate cheering, and we expect to hear it.
Our first graduates are from the Master of Arts in Education, Elizabeth Ann Parpico Jingrich. Clarissa Marie Park. Marissa Ann Boyle. Sarah Elizabeth Killian. Miranda Jo Conley. And now for our graduates of the Master's Arts in Teaching, Lisa May Dixon Casey. Betsy Jo Hahn. Michelle Renee Elson. Elizabeth Waller. Caitlin Marie Morella. Cindy McClure Hurst.
So one more time for the class of 2022. A round of applause. And you may be seated. So to continue celebrating your graduation tonight, please welcome Victoria Van Kirk-Hostetler of the undergraduate class of 2022. She's going to perform No One Is Alone from the Stephen Sondheim musical, Into the Woods. Victoria. Thank you, Victoria. As you can tell, we are really blessed with musical talent here at Muskingum. You saw some of that tonight, so thank you to both of you. So now it is time for the charge to the graduates from our Board of Trustees. And our chair of the board, Dr. Kim Gage Rothermel, is retiring from this leadership position and from the Board of Trustees with the close of this academic year. So Dr. Rothermel is a Muskingum graduate of the class of 1971. She's retired from a distinguished medical career as a private practice pediatrician with board certification in both pediatrics and pediatric hematology oncology. Her professional leadership stretches far beyond our region through her service on the State Medical Board of Ohio. She has had an enormous impact on the lives of her patients, their families, in her profession, and in her community, and also an enormous impact on Muskingum and on me. It has been a true privilege to work with Kim as a leader and as a servant on our board here, and we are so grateful for that service, that leadership, and that stewardship. So please join me in recognizing and thanking Kim now for her service to Muskingum.
Thank you, Dr. Hassler. Will the class of 2022 please rise? Tonight is a momentous occasion that culminates years of determined hard work, greatly challenged by a pandemic that influenced your studies as well as families and employment for some. And yet, you persevered. That perseverance will forever impact your resiliency, creativity, and ability to adapt in whatever field you are working, and will make you more valuable to all you influence, whether it's family and friends, employers, community, church, government, or the world. So my charge to you is never to minimize the impact you can have. As Sheryl Sandberg said, if you are offered a seat on a rocket ship, don't ask what seat, just get on. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, Muskingum University Graduate School Class of 2022, we congratulate you. We are very proud of you.
So thank you, Dr. Rothermel, and as we near the end of our celebration, it's my great pleasure to thank all of you for your participation and to wish all of our 2022 graduates the very best in the future with this charge from the President. May you share your passion for education, business, occupational therapy, leadership, and service with others. May you embrace the challenge, may you take action with your dreams, and may you make the world you live in an even better place. Congratulations and many blessings, class of 2022. And now they need a round of applause. That just sort of, come on. Now, would everyone in the audience please rise in body or spirit for the alma mater, which will be sung by our soloists, Carter Wickham and Victoria Van Kirk Hockstetler.
Life more.
I'd like to leave you this evening with one of my favorite poems. It's titled Beautiful Things, and it was written by Brian Andreas. Once there was a girl who wanted to change the world. And at first, she thought it'd be easy, because if everyone could see how beautiful it'd be, it'd take about a minute. But all the people she talked to were too busy to stop and listen. So she went off and did beautiful things all on her own. And pretty soon, people were stopping and asking if they could come along and do that too. And that's how she figured out how worlds change. As you leave Muskingum, it is my prayer for you that there is a break in the busy, so that you might not only see beautiful things, but will be able to do beautiful things and change the world, even if it's just one student at a time. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his countenance to fall upon each of you and give you peace. Now and always. Amen. Thank you.